Good morning, world. Today, two days before Thanksgiving, I want to talk about a little word that's all over the Bible. Called love. It's been brought to my attention this morning by a friend that I had told her I loved her. Well, she takes this personal and says, are you saying that just to get my attention? I said, no, I love everybody. Down, sit down, get down, boy. Lay down, it's okay. Anyway, I want to share a study of the word as it's in the Authorized King James Version of the Bible that I studied April 9th, 2000. And I wrote all my notes down, so I'm going to share my notes with you today on that particular word, love. I don't tell you every scripture that it's found in, but I will tell you how many different versions, definitions, Old and New Testament, Hebrew and Greek. So when you run across this word love, you might want to consider the context and how you use it in your everyday language, because it can be confusing to some. And like I said, some will take it personal. But anyway, how do I know so much about this? It's for the serious student. There is a book called the Strong's Exhaustive Concordance. It looks like this, and it's a thick book. It has every word in the Bible with the definition. All you have to do is know the scripture you're looking for, go down through it, find the particular passage, and it will give you the original Hebrew and Greek definition in that particular passage. For the serious student, this is a must-have. Okay? These are my notes from the year 2000. It's a word study, love. In the Old Testament, is used 134 times. In the New Testament, 178 times. That's 312 uses of the word love in the total King James Bible. In the original definitions in the original tongue, there are 17 definitions. There are 8 Hebrew definitions in the Old Testament. There are 9 Greek definitions in the New Testament. In the Old Testament, your Strong's number 157 is used 75 times. It is pronounced ahabi, to have affection for, sexually or otherwise. The Strong's number 160, used 36 times. Aheba, affection, good or bad sense. 3 times with the Strong's number 2836. Koshak, to cling, delight in. Once, Strong's number 7355. Kakam, to fondle, have passion for. 7 times, Strong's number 1730. Dode, to boil, to love. Love token, uncle, father's brother. Strong's number 7474. 9 times. Rahya, a female associate. Strong's 5691, used once. Agabon, admirousness, inordinate love. Once, Strong's number 5690, Ekgebe, amenitive words, much love, very lovely. There was only 1 time there is no reference in the Hebrew Old Testament. In the Greek, the New Testament, Strong's number 25, used 70 times. Agapeo, much to love in, a moral or social sense. Strong's number 5368, used 10 times. Phileo, to be a friend, to kiss. The most used, Strong's number 26, used 88 times in the New Testament. Agape, affection, love, feast, charity. Once, Strong's 2309, Philo, to determine acquaintance, preferred choice. One time there is no reference. Strong's number 5360, used four times. Philadelphia, paternal affection, brotherly love. Strong's 5365, used once. Philagorea, love of money. Strong's 5362, used one time. Philandros, fond of man, affection of a wife. Strong's 5388, used once. Philotignos, fond of one's children, maternal. Strong's number 5361, used once. Philadelphos, fond of brethren, paternal. This word love was spoken by our Lord Jesus Christ 45 times. When we hear of agape love, this is misused. That is saying love, love. The word love in Greek is agape. The correct speech would be much agape. So this is about all I have on that word. I thank you for sharing this beautiful afternoon with me and Rusty and the birds. I wish you all a happy Thanksgiving. Especially Mrs. Smiles. She knows who I'm talking about. It's going to be a big gathering for a lot of people. And there are a lot of us that have lost this year. For us, not so much. It's just going to be another day. But anyway, thank you all for letting me share your afternoon.